after 20 minutes you come. Good morning children. Today in this class we will discuss about chapter 3 agriculture. We are going to discuss about agriculture. Here we will make this chapter into three parts. One is introduction, second one is types of farming and major crops. Let us discuss the first one is here, the introduction. As you know, India is a agriculture country. India is a agriculture country. Two-thirds of the people have been engaged in agriculture. People have been producing different crops for our own consumption. Not only crops produces variety of crops that we consume, at the same time agriculture also produces raw materials. Children, let me know, there are some of the raw materials which helps to produce based on the agriculture. Can you name some of the crops like tea, coffee, spices? Even we have been exporting. So agriculture is the most important activity. So agriculture is the backbone of our country. So we have been concentrating, we have been performing this activity since millions of years, right from civilizations. We have been practicing these activities in different ways. Here, types of farming. There are different methods of cultivation of these crops. Here, the methods get classified into three types. The number one is primitive subsistence farming. Number one is primitive subsistence farming. Second one, that is subsistence farming. And third one is commercial farming. Commercial farming. Children, here the methods of farming can be classified three different ways. I'll repeat. Number one, primitive subsistence farming. Number two, subsistence farming. And third one is commercial farming. Commercial, only for the sake of cash. People used to engage certain crops being performing commercial crops. These are the three types, three methods of farming. Children, we will discuss the first one, primitive subsistence farming. What is primitive subsistence farming? Primitive subsistence farming means it is a type of farming done with the by using old tools or equipments such as hoe, dough, digging skill, etc. By using these old equipments, old tools, with the help of their own members of the family or a community. What they produce is, they consume themselves. They consume whatever they get, they consume themselves. They are not going to sell the crop. this type of farming is, you can say, the primitive subsistence farming. Primitive subsistence farming. It is a type of farming done with the help of community or people by using the old equipments. Clear? Such type of farming is called primitive subsistence farming. Primitive subsistence farming. You see, a patch of land cleared, burned and flowing with the help of the own family members or by using the old equipments, cultivate the crops. Whenever this soil loses its fertility in a particular patch of land, immediately people change the place, because already that particular area lost its soil fertility. So therefore, this kind of shifting, this kind of changing place bit by bit or patch by patch, farming will be done. This type of farming we can say as a slash and burn agriculture. Slash. You can say S L A is slash or burn. B-U-R-N, burn agriculture. Generally, it will be done nearby mountains, nearby forests, where the river valleys, ponds, lakes are there, because you can get sufficient water. A patch of land, cut off the trees and burned by clearing, we can cultivate, we can plow this land by using the old equipments, as I said, hoe, dough, digging sickle. These are the tools generally they use right from the ancient period. So cultivation will be done. This type of farming you can say as a slash or burn agriculture. Or you can say jhooming. You can say as a jhooming. We can say as a jhooming, J-H-U-M-M-I-N-G, jhooming. Or you can say shifting cultivation, because we have been shifting again and again. Whenever the soil fertility, land loses its soil fertility, it keep on changes. So therefore, this type of farming, we can say shifting agriculture. Or you can say slash and burn. Or you can say as a shifting agriculture. Jhooming. But this type of farming generally practiced in northeastern states. The slash and burn agriculture normally practiced in India. Particularly in northeastern states like Assam, Meghalaya, Mizoram and Nagaland. So this type of farming is very very familiar, common. It's very common in northeastern states like Assam, Meghalaya, Mizoram and Nagaland. Jhooming, you can say jhooming, or you can say shifting cultivation, or you can say slash or burn agriculture. slash and burn. So this type of agriculture, even if you see other countries like Indonesia, so their people is called as ladang. The people of Indonesia, this kind of agriculture called as a ladang. In Vietnam, they called as roko. In Vietnam, the people use roko. And in Central America, Dipa, America, they called as a Dipa. So they call with different names. Even if you take in India, some of the states like, one is Madhya Pradesh, called Bewari. They called as Bewari in Madhya Pradesh. Podu or Penda. Podu or Penda in Andhra Pradesh. Podu or Penda in Andhra Pradesh. Kumari, they call it as Western Ghats. Kumari in the Western Ghats. Kil in Northeastern states or Northeastern Himalayas. So they kept different names in the different regions according to the areas. The same cultivation, that is Jimmy. This type of cultivation in India also, people use different names. Bewari in Madhya Pradesh, Penda or Podu in Andhra Pradesh, Kumari in Western Ghats, Kil in Eastern Himalayas, and Bring in Orissa. So these are the different names. Locally, people used to keep different names. Local people used to call, use these different names. That is Jumi. Of course, whatever they produce here, people consume on their own. For their needy, whatever they produce, they consume themselves. Not for the sale. This type of farming is called primitive subsistence farming. Primitive subsistence farming. You come here, second one, that is subsistence farming. Second one is subsistence farming. This is the most important method of farming, which is commonly going on the countries like India, the developing countries like India, Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, Pakistan, Nepal. This is very, very common because this farming is practiced wherever there is a huge population. Huge population, large population, I mean to say density population. They used to cultivate mainly in the plain region, northern plains. Here the people practice this method and use the modern techniques and various pesticides and produces. Whatever they comes, they consume themselves, at the same time they will sell in the market. They will sell in the market. This is very, very common. That is second one, substantive forming. Substantive forming. And third one is commercial forming. Basically, this type of forming, people has been engaging only for the sake of business, only for the sake of cash, only for the sake of cash. Examples like cotton and jute, most important commercial crops. And this have been practicing in vast areas. According to the climatic conditions, physical environment, climate and socio-cultural activities. Related to that, these crops will be cultivated. Commercial crops, examples, cotton, jute, other important plantation crops, tea, coffee, rubber, etc. So these are the three types of farming. One is primitive substantive farming. Second one is subsistence farming. And third one is commercial. Here, other than the commercial, when you take about this plantation crops, take a plantation crops. Normally, this type of plantation carried on in large areas, vast areas, by using the modern technology, by using the various pesticides and chemicals, and cultivation with single crop. Cultivation with single crop, not two or more. There is no mixed farming here. The entire land will be cultivated by using only single plant. Coffee, rubber, tea, sugarcane, banana or cinchona, whatever. It should be a only one crop. It should be a single crop. Such type of farming is called as plantation crops. Examples. Examples for plantation crops are tea, coffee, rubber, sugarcane, cinchona, etc. Especially if you take tea and coffee, we call it as a beverage crops. Tea and coffee we consider as a beverage crops. These two crops highly grow in hilly areas. Especially you take tea. You take first one is tea. It is highly cultivated in north states, especially in Assam. Especially in Assam, Meghalaya, and other parts of entire northeast states. Even West Bengal, the plains of West Bengal also, they have been cultivating this. Assam and West Bengal. When you take coffee, particularly this we have been practicing in southern states, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu is well known for coffee. When you take southern region, when you take southern parts of India, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu, the region of Nilgiri Mountains, the region of Baba Bodhan Hills, these are the areas are very very familiar for cultivation of, especially for coffee. कॉफी कल्टीवेशन इन सदर्न रीजन नंबर वन इज नीलगिरी माउंटेन्स वी कॉल इट एज ए ब्लू माउंटेन्स एंड व्हेन यू टेक कर्नाटक बाबा बुदान हिल्स पार्ट्स ऑफ दी बाबा बुदान हिल्स उदक मंडल आई मीन इट इज ऊटी अगेन इट कम्स अंडर तमिलनाडु ऑफ कोर्स बोथ द स्टेट्स नेबरिंग स्टेट्स एंड बॉर्डर्स बाबा बुदान हिल्स उदक मंडल एंड नीलगिरी माउंटेन्स एंटायर रीजन इज प्रैक्टिसिंग दिस कॉफी प्रैक्टिशनर चिल्ड्रन यू नो व्हिच इज द लीडिंग प्रोड्यूसिंग ऑफ कॉफी इन द वर्ल्ड
Yes,
Brazil. Yes. Initially, we bought this. We have been practicing this coffee cultivation. I mean, plantation crop. These seeds which were bought from the Brazil. So they have been thereafter we have been cultivation not only southern and other parts of the country also. The best quality of seeds. There is a name called. Some name has given. So coffee, especially coffee plantation, if you take Karnataka is the number one state in India producing maximum percentage of coffee. Maximum percentage of coffee. So tea and coffee are the best examples for beverage crops. Beverage crops. Whereas if you take cotton and jute. We consider as a fiber crops. Cotton and jute we consider as a fiber crops. Of course, all these can be comes under commercial type of farming. All these crops comes under commercial type of farming. So therefore, children, you have to be very, very careful when you talk about mention any. Two most important plantation crops, we should say yes, tea and coffee. When you talk, give few examples of fiber crops. Best examples are cotton and jute. Give two examples of beverage crops. Yes, tea and coffee. Give few examples of plantation crops. Yes, all together you can give tea, coffee, banana, sugarcane, cinchona, rubber. All these things, all these crops comes under plantation crops. Because these I have been cultivating in a single area, single plot with large area by using the modern technology. Therefore, these crops can be considered as plantation crops. These crops can be considered as a plantation crops. So children here, cultivation of agriculture is here. So type of farming can be classified into three types. Is it clear? The first one is primitive subsistence farming. The second one is subsistence farming. And third one is commercial farming. Under commercial farming, you can take even plantation crops also. Clear? Any doubt, children? Yes. Thank you. Next class, we'll continue with this topic with crops and its types.